Hi, this is Basic Chemistry. Today our new name reaction, Elder N reaction. So let's start. N reaction generally a chemical reaction between alkene, which is also known as enophile, with an allylic hydrogen, which is known as N. So the enophile is like this. And the allylic hydrogen, which is also known as N, it is like this. Before reaction, there are two pi bond, but after reaction, they are generally one pi bond and one pi bond converting to sigma bond. And the reaction goes like this way, and it's generally formed one, two, three, four, five. So generally 1,5 hydrogen shift is there, formation of new CC bond, C2, C3, there is a new carbon bond, and 2 pi bond before reaction, 1 pi bond and 1 sigma bond after reaction. In the Fontaine orbital diagram, there LUMO of enophile react with HOMO of N. If we draw the LUMO of enophile, enophile look like this, and its corresponding LUMO will be like this, where a nodal plane will pass through this CC bond and HOMO of N is like this. It is sigma bond with hydrogen, so the hydrogen is over there, this is carbon and this is the sigma bond, and there is a pi bond, so this is the HOMO and this is the LUMO. Now the interaction over there and the interaction over there, this kind of interaction favors the reaction. This is the basic fundamental of this kind of N reaction. Their enophile is C11C. If we change C1 carbon to oxygen, C double bond O, as the electronegative group will be added to that, like the C double bond N, C double bond S, as the electronegative group will be added, the LUMO energy also decreases, and the energy gap between the HOMO and LUMO decreases. Therefore, there will be a good interaction and the reaction will be more favorable. If we alter the enophile C double bond C to C double bond N, the energy gap decreases, C double bond O, the energy gap between HOMO and LUMO more decreases, and in case of C double bond PH, therefore from right to left, energy gap between HOMO LUMO decreases, this energy gap decreases, therefore the reaction rate from left to right increases, rate also increases. So in case of carbonyl, there will be a good N reaction instead of C double bond C. Now first of all, there should have to be one N and one enophile. Second, this reaction can undergo through high temperature, at presence of high temperature or highly activated substrate. Like if we introduce electron withdrawing group with N, then this center will be more reactive than normal N, because with introducing a electron withdrawing group, LUMO energy decreases, therefore the HOMO LUMO interaction increases, a reaction goes a pretty well manner. Now if we use Lewis acids, then also LUMO energy decreases and a good homo-LUMO interaction occur a good reaction. That's how a Lewis acids helps to catalyze a reaction. Let's say there is my homo of NO5, and this is the LUMO of N. Now, as we increases the electronegativity, or with increasing the Lewis acidity, let's suppose there is a carbonyl group and we introduce a Lewis acid, it will chelate with the oxygen and it will generate a positive charge. Electronegativity of that center increases, therefore the LUMO energy of that carbonyl group will decreases, and therefore the interaction with the homo of NO5 will increases. That's how a Lewis acid helps to catalyze the reaction. There is intramolecular N reaction and intermolecular N reaction. In case of intramolecular N reaction, that is 4 type. In this case, this center pick up the hydrogen and in like this way, it gives this type of product. Second type of reaction, in this model, this center take up this hydrogen, go back there, and this center attacks there. This is the second type. And in third type, the Y center pick up the hydrogen, a double bond form in this position, and this olefin attacks the X center. In type 4, there from this center taking up the hydrogen and followed by this type of reaction giving this type of product. From these 4 type in CSIR, NET, GATE, IIT, JAM, those 4 type are very very important. Just they give this type of substrate, and at under heating condition you have to say what will be the product. Now come to our next topic, asymmetric N reaction. In asymmetric N reaction, if we draw for this example, at presence of this type of Lewis acid, they give this type of product where the seen product is major, near about 90%, and the anti-product is 10%, which is minor. Now, if we draw the transition state, it will be easy to understand. For this case, if we draw a cyclic transition state, in one case, the ester center will be on equatorial, and in another it will be on axial. In this case, if we put it on equatorial and if we take the NO file, which will be like this, and the transition state will look like this, and the Lewis acid over there, then in this transition state the CO2Me is in equatorial and the hydrogen is in axial. But if we draw another possible transition state, the another face of the aldehyde, there CO2Me will be in axial and hydrogen will be in equatorial, and similarly in this transition state the CO2Me is in axial, so this transition is less favorable than this transition state. Now if we draw the product which we will gain from this transition state, this center will take the hydrogen, this bond will go there and attack will be there, so final product will be like this. Now please look carefully, if we take this bond on plane, then hydrogen will be above the plane, methyl will be below the plane, and there OH will be below the plane and hydrogen will be the above the plane. So the picture will be like this. And if we turn the whole molecule over out of plane, then it will give the product A, which is 90%. And from this structure, from this transition state, we will get the product which will be like this: hydrogen, the plane is this, and in this case the OH will be below the plane and CO2ET will be above the plane. This center will be same. If we draw that, will look like this. This will be hydrogen and methyl below the plane, OH below and CO2ET above the plane. There is a CO2ET. Okay, if we take the CO2ET on the plane, so we have to rotate the bond, then OH will be above the plane and methyl will be below the plane. So this is the antiproduct, which is not favorable because the CO2ET on the transition state in the axial position. Therefore this product is major product and this is minor. Okay, this is also very, very important for CSIR NET and GATE exam. How alpha beta unsaturated ketone take part in N reaction? If we draw a resonance structure, it will look like this. This position is positive and this position is negative. So this is electrophilic center and this is nucleophilic center. Now at presence of a NO file, this position is negative. So this take the hydrogen and this bond fall back and this bond take in reaction, because this is electrophilic center. Electrophilic center, as we have seen there, this is a electrophilic center, and through a previous type transition state it will give like this product. Okay, so it will give like this product. So thanks for watching. Subscribe my channel for more tutorial, and for any problem you can email me on basic chemistry helpline@gmail.com.